In the show, Brian Alvarez here, Wrestling Observer Live, Mike Sempervivi, also WrestlingObserver.com. So yes, we did get the Raw ratings, everybody.
Huh.
What a pleasant surprise.
Yay.
1.77 million. And honestly, there's like nothing to talk about. The 3 hours were just... Actually, I guess if there's one thing to talk about, it's three very steady hours. I actually shut the thing off right there, but it was like 1.8, 1.7, 1.6. So people stayed for the show. It was interesting. I did not... How can I say this? I thought a lot of the wrestling was bad, and I thought the Alexa Bliss storyline was just, like, stupid. And, you know, people got mad. Ah, it's brilliant. It's the Joker and Harley Quinn. Dude, I'm not watching the Joker. I'm watching Raw.
Yeah.
Like, whatever you base it on, like, I don't care. Like, I'm sure there's a million storylines on Raw based on whatever, but I'm watching the Raw storyline, and it sucks, okay? So anyway, then I had a lot of people that were like, I actually thought the show was all right. And the show wasn't offensive. I mean, if you don't notice a bunch of botched spots and a bunch of screwed up matches and everything like that, then yeah, the show was fine. And it seems that, like, I guess a lot of people didn't, because the ratings were fine. People watched. They slowly turned off throughout the night. There was no giant plunge. It's just three hours of wrestling that didn't do great, but it was there. That's your Raw ratings report.
If you like Raw and the fare that they give you, you got everything that you wanted on Monday. If you think about it, I mean, if you like what they're giving you, you got it on Monday. So if you're at their main core, you definitely got what you were looking for. It's just so much of it doesn't matter. And if you chuck your brain, I guess, and watch it, then in a vacuum, I guess it's okay and it's fine. But Lucha Underground was able to do things like Alexa and Randy, and it made more sense, because even when we took it away from the cinematic portion of the proceedings and got to the wrestling portion of the proceedings, it was still like you had entered this weird Fight Club pit, and there was an alternative universe to what you usually get with wrestling. WWE is trying to be all things to everybody, so we get a situation where nobody comes out to help the person that's about to be set on fire. The announcers skip from one thing to another thing, and they don't even let this big dramatic thing that's supposed to be happening sink in. And it's just it just juxtaposes each other, and that's even if you love the storylines and what they're doing, there's still pieces that just don't fit on this show. And this storyline, I don't like it as it is anyway. And it just, the storyline within the universe doesn't even make any sense. And it's just, I give Randy Orton and Alexa Bliss credit in a lot of ways for carrying what they're doing. And it could be far worse out of two other people. But it's just that the story that they're carrying is just so, it's so left field, and it's just not working for me in any way, you know, especially the wrestling way, where I want to see Randy Orton and Bray Wyatt, and I guess Bray get his revenge on Randy Orton. It's just, I just don't want to see any of it at all. I mean, it's great. There's great polish on whatever this thing is. It's just, it's all shined up and to me, nowhere to go.
If you love these video clips, head down there to the bottom right-hand side of the screen and click join. For just $7.99 per month, you get full access to all of the episodes. Over 300 at current count. Full-length episodes of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, and Figure Four Daily with both Lance Storm and Filthy Tom Lawler. You can also hit that subscribe button, and you'll always be alerted as to when new shows are available.